Good afternoon and welcome to the Countdown studio on this very, very, very special Countdown day. It's taken 30 years, in a sense, for us to get to where we are today. 68 Countdown series have been screened, more than 5,000 episodes screened here on Channel 4, more than 6,000 contestants, Countdown contestants, have done battle here. So we're very, very proud today to be reaching the final, to be screening the final of the Countdown Champion of Champions. We've got here two of the finest contestants ever to have graced our screens. What do you reckon to all this, Rachel? Have you ever come across such brilliant young people?
They have been fantastic, and it's quite appropriate, really. We're crowning the best champion over the last 30 years. Yep. They've chosen this time to try and make a revival of the 80s-style jumper. So we applaud you. Well done.
Very good indeed. Well done, Rachel. Well done. And who'll be doing battle here in the friendliest of ways? Young Jack Hurst, a maths student at Pembroke College, Cambridge, series champion back in 2010. And in the final, after beating a strong opponent, Jonathan Rawlinson, on a very, very crucial conundrum with a score of 116, adding to his 100% record on Countdown. 16 shows, 16 wins. Another battle of Cambridge maths students because, Jack, you'll be meeting, of course, Connor Travers, the youngest ever series winner, aged just 14 then, studying maths at St John's College, Cambridge. Here in the final, after beating a very worthy John O'Neill on a very crucial conundrum, your third perfect maximum game in a row with a score of 120 out of 120, Connor. Record is now 20 wins from 21 games. Two great guys, and we're really looking forward to you. May the best young chap win. Cambridge wins, that's for sure. All right. Big round of applause for Jack and Connor. Now then, here we are, Friday.
It's Super Friday.
Isn't it Super Friday?
All the way.
Brilliant.
Good luck, guys.
It's just as well we've got Jenny Eclair next to us to keep our feet on the ground, Jenny. And what a pleasure it's been having you here all week.
It's been extraordinary. There's obviously something in the water in Cambridge. I might have to move there.
No, it's great fun, and you've been a joy to have with us, and we'll have a little chat later on
before
we send you off pretty much to Melbourne, Australia, in the firm hope that you won't stay there too long. You'll come back. But now it's time to crack on. It's the final of finals, to crown the Countdown King. Jack, off you go.
Good afternoon, Rachel.
Afternoon, Jack.
Can we start with a consonant, please?
We can, thank you. Good luck to you both. Start the final with C.
And another?
G.
And another?
N.
And a vowel?
E.
And another vowel?
A.
And another?
I.
And a consonant?
H.
And another consonant?
P.
And another consonant, please.
And the last one, T.
And here's the Countdown clock. Now then, Jack.
Eight.
Yes, Connor.
Eight as well.
Thank you, Jack.
I've been doing this the whole way through, cheating.
Oh dear, Connor.
It's a fair contest because I've been cheating too.
You've been both. Well done. Very good. Very good. Eight all. And in the corner, what have we got over there? Susie.
Well, we have peaching, which means informing on someone, patching.
Yes.
And Jenny's got a nice one.
Jenny?
Susie started it and I just kind of followed it up. Nightcap.
What we all need.
Yes.
A nightcap. Very good indeed. All right, eight all. Connor, let us go.
Can I start with a consonant, please?
Thank you, Connor. Start with L.
And another.
M.
And another.
G.
A vowel.
O.
And another.
E.
And another.
I.
Consonant.
S.
Consonant.
R.
And a final vowel, please.
And a final U.
Stand by. Now then, Connor.
Just seven.
Thank you, Jack.
Yeah, seven as well.
OK, Connor.
Misrule.
Misrule. Yes, Jack.
Mousier.
Mousier. Pensive.
Well, Jane's looking thick.
No, you never do.
Well,
what have you got between you over there?
Well, fortunately, it is between us, cos I only got gorse.
Yes. Anything else?
Well, you can be lousier as well as mousier.
Yes.
And there's morgues as well.
Morgues. Keep away from morgues. 15 all. Now then, Jack.
Consonant, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Jack. Y.
And another.
T.
And a third.
P.
And a vowel.
O.
And another.
I.
And a third.
A.
And a consonant, please.
N.
And another.
L.
And we'll go with another consonant, please.
And the last one, S.
Stand by. Yes, Jack?
Seven.
A seven. Connor?
Nine.
Right, Jack.
Soapily.
Thank you. Now then, Connor?
Ponytails.
Right. Are we happy with that?
That was brilliant.
Brilliant. Well done. Ponytails. Well, well done. Look at that. 33 to 15, all of a sudden. But in the corner, what have we got there?
Well, I could have combined what I had and got ponytails, but I didn't.
Yeah.
I got pointy and nastily.
Very good. 33, page 15. Right then, Connor. And you're on again.
Can I have a consonant, please?
Yeah, you're on. Thank you, Connor.
D.
And another.
R.
And another.
S.
And a vowel.
E.
And another.
I.
And another.
A.
Consonant.
T.
Vowel.
E.
And a final consonant, please.
And a final N.
Clock time. Yes, Connor?
Nine.
And Jack?
Yeah, nine.
Thank you. Connor?
Detainers.
Thank you. And Jack?
Resonated.
Very good?
Yes.
Two different nines. Well done.
Brilliant.
Very good. And in the corner?
Well, just to tell you about resonated, it's not resonated as in the sound resonated or something resonates with you. It's with the eye and it's to do with flavouring something with resin, such as resonated white wine.
I see.
That kind
Thank
of resonated.
You. I'm obliged to you. What else have we got there?
Trainees.
Trainees, yes.
Yeah, that's nice. Eight.
Very good. Anything else interesting?
Nothing more.
OK, that'll do. 33 plays 51. Connor's 51. But it's your numbers game, Jack.
Well, Connor's got two nines, so I could try and help him get a nice high score, but I think I need to come back, so I'll pick four large, please.
Four large. I don't think Connor's too scared about that. I think he's a pretty much an all-rounder. Let's have a look what we've got here. The two small ones. We have 9 and another 9. This could be very tricky. And your 4 large. 25, 100, 75 and 50. And now the target, 483.
483. Yes, Jack?
484.
484. Connor?
484.
All right, let's hear from Jack first.
950s are 450.
950s are 450.
And 25 and 9 is 34.
25 and the other 9, 34.
Add it on.
484. One away.
Thank you. Connor, the same route. You happy? Happy, Jack?
Yeah.
Fine, so one away. What does Rachel have to say? Is that as near as possible?
I think I might have actually won one game against these two.
Come on, then, let's see.
Let's have a go. 100 times 9, 900. 75 minus the other 9, 66. Add them together for 966. And then 50 over 25 is 2, and divide it.
Brilliant. Well done. Very good, but what does it do to the score here? 58 to 40 still, as we turn now to Jenny Eclair.
This is apparently a true story. I didn't hear it from the horse's mouth.
Go on.
Or any end of the horse. But apparently this is a story about the Queen. And she was taking a visiting dignitary for a state ride. It was one of those big doos down the Mall. Horse-drawn carriage. And very suddenly, the horse broke wind. Hugely. And, of course, the Queen very politely said to her, the visiting dignitary, "I'm so sorry," to which he replied, "Until you apologised, Mum, I'd have assumed it was the horse."
Very good. I heard a lovely story about the Queen the other day. Funnily enough, from one of our guests here in Dictionary Corner, I won't mention his or her name, but this person happened to be in Kenya with the Queen and Prince Philip when they returned to treetops. And it was a big thing. And she or he cleverly said, was allowed up into treetops with the Queen and Prince Philip. And the Queen, she heard, or he heard, the Queen actually say, "Philip, have we been here before?" And he said, "Yes, but I don't know what they've done with all the trees." Apparently, she's completely unsentimental. And that, of course, is where she heard about the sad death of her father.
Could have been trauma, Nick. Could have been trauma.
But no, but this was sort of, you know, 40 years later, or whatever it was. But anyway, Philip, have we been here before? Brilliant, isn't it? But now, I hope she's not watching. It's time for a tea time teaser, which is Ice Clash. And the clue, these large cups have a religious connection. These large cups have a religious connection. Welcome back. I left you with the clue. These large cups have a religious connection. Because they're chalices. Chalices. Some people are unfortunate enough to have a poison chalice. Now, 58 to 40. Connor in the lead. Connor, your letters game.
Can I have a consonant, please, Rachel?
Thank you, Connor. L.
And another?
M.
L.
I.
And another?
E.
And another?
O.
Consonant?
N.
A vowel?
A.
And a final consonant, please.
And a final R.
Countdown. Yes, Connor.
9.
Thank you. Jack?
Yeah, this is getting a bit silly. I've got 9 as well.
All right, never mind. Connor?
Normalise.
Normalise. Both of you?
Yeah, same.
All right, yeah. Jolly good. Well done, well done, well done. 3 9s in a row. Well done, Connor. Now then, Jack, letters game.
Consonant, please, Rachel.
Don't think that's ever been done before. Right.
Or a fire engine.
Okay. 999.
Good one. Right. Let's try for 4. G.
And another.
T.
And another.
That's clever, that is. S.
And a vowel, please.
I.
And another.
E.
And a third.
O.
And a consonant, sorry.
F.
And a vowel, please.
A.
And another vowel, please.
And the last one. I.
Tick-tock time. Yes, Jack?
6.
And Connor?
6 as well.
OK. Jack?
Fiesta.
Thank you, Connor.
And ageist.
Ageist.
Yes.
Very good. We happy?
The E, I'm very happy. Yes.
Very good. Any advances? Jenny?
I got stuck.
Focus. Very
Not
good.
Not that you are one.
Well, I'm heading that way.
Anything else?
Egoist.
Egoist.
There,
well. There we are.
You like
there
that one
we
better.
Are. I prefer that. 82 plays 64. Now then, Connor.
Can I have a consonant, please, Rachel?
Thank you, Connor. L.
And another.
H.
And another.
R.
And a vowel.
E.
And another.
O.
And another.
I.
A consonant.
C.
A consonant.
T.
And a final consonant, please.
And the last one. D.
Countdown. Connor?
8.
Jack?
8 as well.
Thank you. Connor?
Chlorite.
Chlorite. Jack?
Chortled.
Chortled. That's a nice word.
Yes, one of my favourite words, chortled. It was coined by Lewis Carroll.
Really?
Yeah, and it was a blend of chuckle and snort. That's where he got it from.
As recently as that?
Yeah. From Through the Looking Glass, he coined
Very good. It. Very good. Anything word. Else? From Jenny,
I got chortled. I got chortled.
Yes, anything else between you?
No, nothing beyond that.
Jenny makes us chortle. Very good. 90 plays, 72. Now then, Jack, letters game.
Consonant, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Jack. V.
And another.
N.
And a third.
W.
And a vowel, please.
E.
And another.
A.
And a third.
S.
And another, please.
And lastly, D.
Stand by. Jack?
8.
Thank you. Connor?
Eight as well.
OK, Jack's eight?
Not sure if it's in. Vend aces.
Yes, and how about Connor?
Same word. Cool.
Yeah. Very good. Two vend aces. And they are...?
They are edible whitefish found in lakes in northern Europe. And in Britain, you'll only find them in two lakes, and they're in the Lake District.
Hey, vend ace. Very good. But the barrier remains, 98 to 80. As we look to you, Susie. Susie, we sit at your knee with our pencils sharpened and our pieces of paper poised.
This gets me worried, that. Well, I wouldn't exactly call this a halcyon day, because lovely as they are and lovely as this is, it's not exactly tranquil here in the studio. But it's not an albatross day either, I would say, because there's no burdens on Connor or Jack. They've come so far. But the story of the albatross is a nice one. In Arabic, al-gatas meant the diver, and it was applied to the penguin. And when the word reached Spain, it became Alcatraz, and it was applied not just to the penguin, but also to an island in San Francisco Bay where hundreds of pelicans would flock. And, of course, that later became the name for the state penitentiary, Alcatraz. And when albatrosses were first discovered, they were given the name of the bird which it seemed at the time to resemble most, and that was the Alcatraz. Centuries later in English, we changed it to the albatross. And to have an albatross around your neck, of course, is a heavy burden, and that goes back to Coleridge's rhyme of the Ancient Mariner. The shooting of an albatross by a mariner arouses the wrath of the spirits. The mariner is forced by his fellow sailors to hang the dead bird around his neck to illustrate the burden that comes from killing it. And the spirits ensure a very heavy punishment. Essentially, he lives life in death. But I didn't mean to be morose or somber today, because it would be lovely if we could call it a halcyon day, but I think we need a new adjective. Wonderful, but quite tense.
Indeed. Thank you so much. Thank you. Beautifully delivered. Not a spare word. It was lovely. Great to listen to. Thank you, Susie, so much. Now then, Connor 98 to Jack's 80, as we go into a numbers game. Connor?
Can I just have one large and five small,
One
please?
Large and five small. Thank you, Connor. And you're possibly on your way to an even bigger score than Jack managed last time. Let's see. The five small this time are 10, 7, another 7, 6, 8, and the large one, 50. And the target, 616.
616. Yes, Connor.
I think I've got 616 not fully written down.
All right, Jack?
616 written down.
OK, so, Connor?
50 plus 6.
50 plus 6. 56.
7 over 7.
7 over 7 is 1.
Add it to the 10.
11.
And multiply.
Well done, 616.
Very good.
Relief.
Yeah, I bet. Jack?
Different method. 7 times 10.
7 times 10, 70.
Add 7.
Add 7, 77.
Times 8.
Times 8, same difference.
Six, well done, six. Both of you. Well done. Well done. 108 plays 90, but now it's time for a tea time teaser, which is hits, aces. And the clue, tell Charlie off about his neckwear, perhaps. Tell Charlie off about his neckwear, perhaps. And the answer is chastise. Chastise. Now then, 108 to 90. Connor in the lead. Jack, take it away for a letters game.
Consonant, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Jack. B.
And another.
K.
And another.
M.
And another.
S.
Vowel.
I.
Another vowel.
U.
Another vowel.
I.
Another vowel.
E.
And another vowel, please.
Doesn't look like a nine to me out of this lot. The last one, O.
Stand by. Oh, Jack?
Six.
Six. And Connor?
Yeah, six.
OK. Six. Jack?
Imbues.
Imbues.
Yeah.
Connor? Yes. They're both imbued here.
Yes.
And in our famous dictionary corner, Jenny and Susie?
I got bikes, which is five.
That's very good.
No, it is good, because I think...
Any more?
I think imbues is probably the only six, or certainly the only one I could get. Yeah, just five, mouse, sebum, otherwise.
OK.
Yeah.
Very good. Well done, both of you. 114.96. Connor.
Can I have a consonant, please, Rachel?
Thank you, Connor. R.
And another.
G.
And another.
D.
A vowel.
U.
And another.
A.
And another.
O.
A consonant.
X.
A vowel.
U.
And... a final vowel, please.
Another naughty selection. Last one, A.
Countdown. Connor?
Just five.
And Jack?
Yeah, five as well.
OK, Connor?
Agora.
Agora?
God.
Agora.
How are you spelling that?
A-G-O-R-A?
Yeah, A-G-O-R-A. It... sorry to get you worried. It's a public open space used for assemblies and markets, which is why, of course, agoraphobia means fear of going into the markets or fear of open space.
I see. Very good. 119.
Happens here. consonant, please.
Thank you, Jack. B.
And another.
D.
And a third.
S.
And a fourth.
M.
And a vowel.
Let's find some nicer vowels. E.
And another.
A.
And a third.
E.
And a fourth.
O.
And a consonant, please.
And lastly, P.
And they're off. Jack?
Six.
Thank you. Connor?
Seven.
Yes, Jack?
Soaped.
Thank you. Connor?
Pomades.
Pomades.
Yes, to rub that scented ointment in your hair.
Brilliant stuff. Pomades.
Pomade. Well done.
Yeah. Very, very good. Pomades.
I got mopeds.
That's very nice. Good. Anything else?
No. No, I just got that comes from a Swedish word, which means pedal cycle with motor and pedals, but is much more succinct.
Mopeds, yeah, very good. Pomades takes the day, then, 126 to 101. But, Connor, it's our last numbers game. Over to Rachel.
Can I just have one large and five
you
small,
can,
please?
Of course. You've already won. And with two more rounds, you could match the all-time high score, so I will try my best to pick a nice one for you. For the last time in this final, the numbers are 10, 7, 8, 6, another 10, and 100. And your target, 945.
945. Yes, Connor?
945, yes.
945. Jack?
Yeah, 945.
OK. And Connor?
100 minus 6.
100 minus 6, 94.
Multiply by 10.
940.
And then 8 plus 7.
8 plus 7, 15.
Minus 10.
Minus the other 10 for the 5.
And add that on.
And very well done.
Jack's got the same route.
Same method, yeah.
Yep, well done. Very good. Darren Connor, you're reaching for the stars, 136. And you know the max is at 146 so far.
Yeah.
Now then, fingers on buzzers, please. It's conundrum time. Let's reveal the final countdown conundrum. Whoa!
Leviathan?
Leviathan, let's see what you're right. Brilliant. Oh, well done. Yes! Well done. That deserved wolf whistles, Connor. That really did. 146, you did it. Brilliant.
Wow, can't
excellent
believe it.
Excellent stuff. Well done. But we must say farewell to Jack.
Yep.
Bravura performance, 111. Well done.
Thank you.
We're very sorry to see you go. On the day, you know, Connor swept through.
Yeah, I'd just like to say well done to Connor. I honestly think he's the best full time. I was such an honour to play against him in the final.
That's very generous of you, but listen, don't do yourself
player.
In. Because you are a great competitor and a great countdown candidate. Thanks very much. Back with your kryptonite trophy to show off in your college and a teapot so you can serve tea to all your fellow students, yes? And go with our blessing and good luck. What will you do with your degree when you finish now?
I don't know. If anyone out there wants to give me a job when I graduate, I mean, I'm not... I didn't win, but, yeah, second's not bad, so...
Don't you worry. There'll be a lot of people queuing up for you, young man. Brilliant stuff.
Thanks.
And to present our trophy to our winner, allow me to present the great Marcel Stelman, who 30 years ago brought Countdown to these shores.
Thank you.
Marcel, you've created something, a British institution.
I thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, I am more than honoured to be here. It's not my habit to be shown on television. Today is an exception. And I must thank so many people. But first of all, may I, with your permission, present this lovely trophy to Connor for having been one of the greatest all-time winners of the champion of champion of champions.
Yes, Connor.
I would like to thank the team that's been with me all the time. I'm only a member of a team. I don't do the work. The team does the work. And for that, I need to congratulate and applaud the warmest people I've ever known who have worked with us to keep this show on the road. Nick, my great presenter, Rachel, our wonderful mathematician, Susie Dent on the dictionary corn, and also a lady who is not on the show, but was here. The first lady on the show 30 years ago, Cindy Ritzer. Give her a round of applause.
Yes. So that's it. We've got our countdown champion of champions, young Connor here. So, well done. Travel safely. And you, young man. And Susie, thank you so much.
Thank you.
As ever, Rachel, bless you. Thank
you
so much. Jenny, great pleasure. And we're back with the mortals next week, same time. You be here, you be sure of it. Good afternoon.
Flapjacks, you can never go wrong. Rosé prawn pesto pasta, though, sounds delightful. Jamie's Quick and Easy Food is all new and starts tonight at 8. But this is a question on all of our minds right now. A place in the sun, home or away, is here next.